Hello, everybody. Well, you just never know where inspiration is going to come from. I actually was at the hardware store the other day and saw some bundled firewood for sale. And I thought to myself, yep, I'm going to make a bowl out of that. Well, you can see there's a lot of splits and cracks and checks in this wood. It's nothing special. So my first task was to mill it down, cut it into slabs. I got them fairly close here, about a half inch thick. You can see the cracking there. So I did the rough cuts on the bandsaw. And then I moved to the table saw. You can see there's the there's all the offcuts, the unusable stuff. Well, it's usable. It's winter. I'll use it. Now it's just a matter of getting everything down to equal sizes. So off cuts and crack stuff on the left as you're looking at it. The stuff in the middle still had some cracks, but it was mostly usable. And a whole bunch of nice kindling for the wood-burning stove. I decided to make a segmented bowl using 12 segment rings, which means you have to cut at 15 degrees. So here's 12 little pieces. I made a total of 5 rings, so 60 segments, plus the base. And I'm just going to show the cutting and glue up of one ring. And this is just a homemade chart that I have, and this tells me how long the segments need to be on the long side of the segments. It just gives me about a half inch overlap from ring to ring. This is just a piece of, it might be white oak. I'm not really sure, to be honest. Just something I had laying around. I thought it would make a nice pretty base for this bowl. Thank you. All right, well, it's time to look at some subscriber projects. Love this. Mr. Ashley Leonard made these. And I love a natural edge bowl. That one's gorgeous, too. That's some great work there, Ashley. Gorgeous. David Madursky made these. You might know him as Uncle Mo, a frequent contributor to my channel, longtime subscriber, and quite the artist on the lathe. A couple of great wood turners. And I want to thank all of my subscribers. I really appreciate every single one of you. I hope you like it. And I hope you can see that you don't need to go to an expensive woodworking store and buy exotic wood to make a beautiful thing on a lathe. A few dollars for a bundle of wood at the hardware store. That's what this is. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching. I sure appreciate it. God bless and Semper Fi.